I be that young rapping dude, might just trap with you. Coming with the thunder, baby, might just clap it through. I roll out in the morning light, whip that Harley bike. All black, I'm the party type, and it's on tonight. I just stepped in, no weapons, but my outfit might take the soul. See my presence impressive, got strippers slipping off of poles. I just whip, then I swerve and wish you would. I'm Timmy Turner, turned her to a carnival. Hey, what's up guys, Darkbreaker here, and for today's video we are going to play Darius again. For the matchup it's going to be Darius against Camille, and we are going to use the Protobelt enchantment, which is actually really good for a lot of cheese outplays. With the Protobelt into a hook, you can catch people off guard and initiate combos, so that's really neat. Anyways, Camille is probably a pretty hard matchup. It's a skill matchup in my opinion, and honestly it depends. I would say in general a really good Camille will be better than a good Darius, but otherwise it's just, I mean, it can go either way. If you're a really good Darius, you might be able to beat Camille, but I would say in general, if both players have equal skill, then Camille should be winning in this matchup. Maybe not in the early game, but she's definitely going to outscale you starting level 8 or something. When both have one item, like when she has Trinity and you have Trinity, I guess it can go either way, but once both people have two items, I would say it definitely goes into Camille's favor. I have my orders. So we're going for Barrier, and I think that's a really consistent talent for Darius, because you can cheese people with it. Like, they think, oh, they can kill you. But five stacks, yeah, let's go. Nice bleeding. When you get 5 stacks onto someone, you're going to get Noxus Might, which is going to boost your AD by a lot, and also 5 stacks of bleeding are going to help like a truck. It's probably going to backport, so I would just shove in the wave quickly, so he might lose a few minions to the turret. First blood goes to the enemy Wukong. Like I said, the Talent Barrier is really good to bait people into thinking that they can kill you, and it gives you more time to get those 5 stacks. And the moment you have 5 stacks, your ultimate does so much damage that you can almost do like minimum 50% of damage with just your ultimate. Also going to get boots, so it's easier for me to keep up with the Camille. So for Camille, she wants to go for short trades and then dash out, and Darius wants to have prolonged fights. So you want to have long fights to get those 5 stacks off, and then you use your ultimate and you just kill her. So how do you accomplish that? If you can manage, okay, Wukong is coming, never mind, let's jump out. I got 4 stacks already. Wait, auto attack onto him. Wait, why didn't I get the 5 stack? I think he wasn't in his, I think he was still in his normal form and didn't use his clone. Maybe I just hit the clone and he used it earlier. It's actually really annoying that if you hit the clone, you're not going to get bleeding stacks. Otherwise, I could have turned it. Or maybe if I hit the Wukong earlier before he activated his clone, I would get 5 stacks, use my ultimate onto him, and maybe be able to turn this. So Darius is definitely really great at turning. Okay, didn't hit it. Let's just back off. I missed my hook, so I will just retreat right here. Darius is really good at winning 1v2 situations, especially with Barrier. You will have the opportunity to get those 5 stacks, and then you can easily turn a 1v2. On my way.
Also, the lower you are, the more you're going to heal. And if you hit your S1 onto multiple people, it's going to grant you a huge healing boost. Missed my hook again. I tried to hit it on Orianna. Okay. We got it. It's nice. You don't even need to use my ultimate. He dies already. Let's see if we can go for... Okay, Lee Sin is just going to run into them and die. Let's go. If they come here, we can turn. I can pull her. No, I didn't hit it. That was so close. We managed to force the barrier though. And we got Inferno, so... Overall, not too bad. Even though it was a 1-for-2 in terms of kills. They're not going to go for Scuttle because Wukong is there, and then if Camille comes, she just press ultimate and I die, so better not try it. Okay, he hits me. 5 stacks, ultimate. I still have my barrier as well. And he dies, let's go. Oh my god, I didn't get the Kata minion! Oh no! Wait, I think I might die here. I should have just backed off. I had to use 2 summoners for this. That was actually greedy. I knew Wukong was at the bottom side, so I should have done that. Okay, if Lee Sin comes, we can turn. Yeah, this Wukong is solo, we can turn this. Okay, that's him. Wait, why is he not moving? I guess he's like, okay, I accept my fate. I'm going to die no matter what. So, get it over with! I'm dead, just kill me. Just pinging, he's low, we can dive this easily if he comes. Oh, he doesn't come. Oh, I missed the hook. But I don't think I could have killed him with that. I have my orders. We should be able to get the kill. I mean, the kill onto the turret. Never mind. Was that first turret? Yeah, it was. Nice. Retreat. Stay alert. 6.5k, not too bad.
My destination is clear.
Just going to get the fruit for some extra gold. Dragon is not going to spawn soon, so I will just deep push the wave first, and then I will try to roam. Hopefully, I mean, Camille might be coming top already. Oh, she's still here. Okay, got her. Ultimate. Oh my god, she was out of vision and then she just flashed out because I didn't move into the bush. I misplayed. I could have just used my ultimate at 4 stacks immediately. Oh, I just entered the bush quickly. What was that? I grieved. I totally grieved. But as you guys can see, you can also use the hook flash combo to immediately hook someone without them being able to react, and that's pretty neat. So at least you saw how to use that combo at least. And Wukong managed to steal the dragon. It's Batman. But yeah, if you just flash and use your hook, they have some time to react, but if you hook and then flash, there's like zero chance that they can react in time. and you will hook them no matter what. Then use one auto attack, use your second skill. You have 3 stacks. Hook, auto attack, S2, and then S1, another auto attack, and then you have 5 stacks ultimate, and they are pretty much meat. Anyways, this game is so low kill. 8 kills in 10 minutes. That's so low. That's surprisingly low. Like, usually I would see, like, I don't know, 20 kills at 10 minutes probably. But 8 kills? That's so insanely low. Okay, nice charm. Just looking whether or not I can find the protobelt engage combo. Never mind.
On my way.
Make no mistakes.
Retreat from the enemy champion. Root.
Noxus will run.
Let's backport.
Bottom turret is under attack. Bottom turret is under attack.
Yeah. I think that was actually a good trade for Wukong. They're behind, he's getting a turret. That's global gold for the team. Some people would say, yeah, that's an int, but hey, he got one kill at one turret at least. Protobelt E. Actually, I thought I might, okay, still secure the kill with a flash S1. Okay, blocked him. He still managed to use the ultimate onto Ahri and just going to die. S1 and he dies. 4 kills for us, not too bad. I mean, yeah, they lost Baron because Wukong died. Yeah, actually it was not a good trade, I take it back. If it was a side laner who did that, get the turret and die for it, I would say it's worth it. But since it was the jungler, they just my team just forced the Baron, and it was pretty much free because there was no way for them to steal without Wukong. Yeah, he probably just used the clone to enter the top bush, whatever. Can't be bothered trying to chase Wukong. Anyways, we're pretty damn big. We have Trinity, Starrux, and Guardian Angel. We are super strong. Could go for Death Dance next item for increased lifesteal, and it would Death Dance is probably a really great item on Darius. If you want to go for more damage build, this one is going to be pretty damn juicy because you will get can't chase. You will get AD, HP, cooldown reduction, and also the passive, which is going to reduce the damage taken. I mean, you still take the damage, but you take it over time, so it's pretty good for Darius. Okay, this is a pretty damn nice pull from us with the protobelt engage. That's what I mean with protobelt engage, you can make big plays happen, and also with the flash hook engage, you can make pretty nasty combos. Especially if you go for a really tanky build, you stun them. People forget that the hook also stuns the opponent, so if you use hook flash into multiple people, it's a great engage tool for your teammates, because they're getting stunned. Anyways, next item is going to be Death Dance.
danger.
With overwhelming force, Noxus will rise.
We have so much gold over the enemy Camille. We are huge. We have 5k on her.
My destination
8 kill participations as well, so we're doing pretty damn good job so far.
On my way.
I guess we can just go for Baron and then afterwards finish the game. Let's see if we can zone. Okay, really aggressive. Okay. I just use Protobelt to keep in range with them. Okay, godlike. Let's go. And did you see the damage we do? The moment we enter Noxus Might, we are just absolutely broken. Anyways, that's going to be it for the gameplay. I hope you guys enjoyed the Protobelt plays we did on Darius. And yeah, if you guys enjoyed this gameplay, then definitely leave a like. And I see you for tomorrow's video. Bye bye.